And today we are going to discuss edible vaccines. So first is, what is edible vaccines? Edible vaccines are the transgenic plant which are prepared through incorporating a particular gene of interest into the plant, which produces the desirable encoded protein. Edible vaccines offer systemic immunity as well as mucosal immunity. Edible vaccines also offer cost-effective oral administration, storable and widely acceptable as a biofriendly, particularly in developing countries. Edible vaccines also reduces the incidence of various diseases like hepatitis and diarrhea, etc. Edible vaccines, where we used various foods that are used as a alternative agents for injectable vaccines, included cereals, wheat, rice, corn, fruits, bananas, vegetables, lettuce, potatoes, tomato, etc. When we talk about the history, the first demonstration of an edible vaccine was the expression of surface antigen, that is Streptococcus mutans, which is found in tobacco plant and it causes dental caries. But later on, scientists found that the bacterial antigen could stimulate the immune mucosal immune response that would prevent bacteria from colonizing the teeth. That is why it protect against tooth decay. When we talk about the mechanism of action, the oral vaccine generate mucosal immunity, antibody mediated immunity and cell mediated immunity. Edible vaccine, where the release of antigen and its breakdown from plant vaccine, it occurs near pairs patches of intestine, and antigen is then taken up by M cell and is presented to B cells, where the B cells is activated and get differentiated into plasma cells and secrete IgA antibodies. It is a type of antibodies and elicit mucosal and humoral immunity. It also affect on T cells, and T cell immune response recognize pathogens and directly kill the invader themselves. Now the method of developing an edible vaccine, there are the two ways or methods: gene encoding antigen from pathogenic organism like viruses, bacteria or parasites that have been characterized and for which antibodies are available. They produce in the edible parts of the plants in two ways. What are the two ways? In first case, the entire structure gene is inserted into a plant transformation vector. So first is transformation vector, where this will allow transcription and accumulation of coding sequence in plant. In second case, epitope within the antigen are identified. What is epitope? Epitope are the part of antigen where the antibodies is attached. So first we identify the epitope part of the antigen, then we construct a gene by DNA fragment encoded and with coat protein gene from plant viruses. We are using plant viruses like TMV, tobacco mosaic virus, or CMV, cucumber mosaic virus. Then the recombinant virus is then used to infect stabilize plant, and we prepared edible vaccine successfully. These are the examples of vaccine, edible vaccines. First is hepatitis B, where tobacco potato and lettuce used as a vector. Second is Norwalk virus, where tobacco and potato used as a vector, and these are used in the treatment of diarrhea, nausea and stomach cramps. Third is rabies virus, transmissible gastroenteritis, coronavirus, rabbit hemorrhagic disease virus, HIV virus, vibrio cholera. So we are using generally a different kind of vector and in different diseases like rabies, gastroenteritis, hemorrhage, AIDS and cholera. Now the advantages of edible vaccine. Now we are little aware about what is edible vaccines. Now we compare the advantages and disadvantages of edible vaccine. So first is advantages. The first point is it have efficient mode of action for immunization. Why? Because they do not require subsidiary elements to stimulate immune response. They directly act on act as a immunization. Second is edible vaccines are comparatively cost effective because we are using plant, as they do not require also cold chain storage as traditional vaccines are stored in a cold temperature. Third is edible vaccine do not need sophisticated equipments and machinery in the preparation as well as to store them. Next point is they could be easily grown on rich soil and the method is economical as compared to cell culture we are growing in a fermenter when we prepare a journal traditional vaccines. Edible vaccines, we all know these are the orally administered, so the requirement of trained medical personnel and the risk of contamination, we are using different equipments or instrument to inject the vaccine, so the risk of contamination is reduced. Edible vaccine do not need premises and manufacturing areas where the sterilization is needed or mandatory. Next point is edible vaccine production process can be scaled up by the breeding method. Edible vaccines also offer great storage opportunities in the form of seed of transgenic plants. Now the disadvantages of edible vaccines. Edible vaccines administration required method for standardization of plant material. So the first disadvantage is that the standardization of plant material is mandatory where we use a material or the product of transgenic plant, because if the variation is occur, low dose may produce lesser number of antibodies and high doses are responsible for immune tolerance. Edible vaccines are dependent on plant stability, as certain foods cannot be eaten raw, example potato, and need cooking that cause denaturation or weaken the protein present in it. Edible vaccines are prone to get microbial infestation. These are the example, like potato containing vaccine can last long if stored at 4 degree or below the cold temperature, while the tomato can't last long. So these are the advantages. Continuation in disadvantages. Doses required varies from generation to generation, plant to plant, protein content, patient age, weight, ripeness of the fruit, and the quality of the food eaten also varies. Proper demarcation line is also necessary between vaccine fruit and normal fruit to avoid misadministration of vaccine, which can lead to vaccine tolerance. So vaccine tolerance also can be occurred. So these are the disadvantages. Now the application of edible vaccines. Edible vaccines also used in autoimmune diseases and other diseases like malaria, hepatitis, measles. Other than disease, it also used in birth control, in a cancer therapy, agriculture, other industry, biotechnology. These are the applications. So first is malaria. Malaria, it is one of the most significant cause of human morbidity and mortality worldwide. We know, with 300 to 500 million new cases of infection are coming annually, which leads to 1.5 to 2.7 million death. Currently, three antigens are being investigated for the development of plant-based malaria vaccines. What they are? First is myrozoite surface protein, MSP4 and MSP5 from Plasmodium falciparum, MSP4 or 5 from Plasmodium ureum. It also used in the treatment of hepatitis B. The hepatitis B surface antigen is used as a vaccine against hepatitis B. The HBsAg subtype was cloned into CAMV plasmid, and the regenerated plants from the transformed cell were shown to produce hepatitis B surface antigens. Edible vaccines also effective in the treatment of measles, as we are using tobacco, potato, rice, lettuce, and they have the satisfying result. Edible vaccines now used also in a cancer therapy, where we generate monoclonal antibodies that have been verified as an effective cancer therapy agent. We have the example, monoclonal body in case of soybean, BR96, is an efficient agent that attacks doxorubicin, responsible for breast cancer, ovarian cancer, colon cancer, lung cancer, etc. Edible vaccines also used in the treatment of birth control. Administration of TMV, tobacco mosaic virus, which produces protein that is found in Moseona pellucida, that is ZB3 protein, and is capable of preventing fertilization of egg. It prevents the fertilization of egg in mice due to resulting antibodies. So this is all about edible vaccine.